Hello and welcome CIS244 Systems Analysis / Project Management students. Eric Magidson here. I will be your instructor for this course. Let's jump into the welcome video and the topics we need to cover today. So by opening a browser, logging into Canvas, each week you will receive this week, welcome to the course and week one video. From here on out, a welcome to the week video that details everything you need to know for the week. Thus, the expectation is that you'll be watching this video early on in the week and scheduling and managing your time to meet your personal goals and be successful in this course. So this communication is delivered to you two ways. It should A, be coming in your email, and B, you can always find it. I'll show you this in just a minute. On the home tab, when you open up a new course, it should take you right to the home tab and you'll see announcements at the top. So make sure you're looking for those and consuming all of the information in there. A lot of times the questions that I get asked about the course in the first week or questions that I get asked throughout the subsequent weeks are answered in this video. So please make sure that you watch this video. So like this week, you'll see that the first week you have two attendance requirements. You must complete these attendance requirements in order to remain in the course. So what they do is they demonstrate that you're active in the course the first week, and thus you plan to continue to be active in the course the subsequent week. So make sure you do not miss these deadlines or you will be automatically withdrawn from the course. We'll look more at these in a minute. This week, you also have some homework due. Chapter 1 homework, and then part of Chapter 2. So I've broken the course up based on my own taking of the course, if you will, as well as what students have said the coursework is each week to balance out the coursework in this course. So let's move on from here. So you'll get this. Let's go to the home tab and take a look. Now, I'm not going to go through this in great detail because as a 200 level course, you should by now have a massive experience in managing Canvas and in managing courses, managing your time, etc. And most likely you may have taken a course from me previously, so you know my structure, outcomes, requirements, etc. On the home tab, when you come to it the first time, you will see that notification for the welcome to the course and week one video there. There are links to the primary things that you'll want to access via Canvas, but those are also listed here. So moving on, Zoom Office. So I have office hours that are listed. I'll show you those in just a minute. But let me detail that my office hours is not the only time that I'm available, okay? I tend to have my Zoom open as much as I can if I'm not doing something where I need privacy, where I'm doing my deep work or my focus time. I schedule time each day now to do focus deep work. I won't be on Zoom at that time, but I keep my Zoom open way more than just the scheduled office hours that you'll see here in a minute. With that said, the best way to get a hold of me is through MS Teams. We'll talk about that as well. So let's jump into modules, but before we do that, let's just cover the late voucher form. So over here, there is a late voucher form. This is a new process and procedure for late voucher forms for 2023. So make sure you read this in detail so you know that if you get into a jam where either hopefully you haven't procrastinated, but you get towards the end of the week, something happens in life, you get ill, someone else gets ill, a child gets ill, whatever the case may be, you have the opportunity to have 4 days to turn that homework in only for 1 week, okay? So, you know, read this thoroughly so that you understand and make sure you fill this out prior to the deadline for the assignment. Now, the majority of the time you're going to spend right here in modules. This course is a heavy textbook course and a lecture course. There is no e-learning component. So consequently, there isn't an e-learning systems outside of Canvas that's embedded in this course, okay? So you've got that welcome to the week video, welcome information here, sort of a process of where you want to go, what you want to do, course syllabus and schedules. So let's cover these real quick. Here in the start here, first day, you'll find the course syllabus. You're going to want to make sure you read this in detail. The attendance requirement number 2 is a syllabus quiz that you're going to complete, and you should have read this this syllabus in detail. The last thing you're going to do is sign and agree that A, you have read the entire syllabus, and you agree to the terms and conditions where within. You'll need to grab this textbook. Other information you need for the course is in the syllabus. I'm not going to waste your time by going through it. Read the syllabus. You'll get that information. Come down here. You get a schedule of everything that's due. You can certainly click here. You can also download, print this, move it to a PDF, you know, synchronize it with your digital assistant calendar on your smartphone, whatever you need to do to make sure you meet these deadlines. Every assignment is listed here, including those attendance requirements and the reminder that those are actually due on noon, not at 11:59. So make sure you meet that deadline. The first one is due Wednesday this week. The second one is due Friday, both at noon. The majority of other assignments are due at 11:59 p.m. on Thursday or Monday. So just an FYI, but make sure that you review this in detail and schedule your time accordingly. Going back into modules, you'll find instructor contact and calendar information here. This lists how to contact me. My preferred method of communication now is MS Teams. Now, a lot of students ask, why am I using all this different software? The reason is, in business, this is what you're going to use to communicate. Emails have a purpose. Chat or MS Teams has a purpose to group people to better communicate as a team, as a department, as a company. Okay, so you're going to get the opportunity to practice that there. Let's go ahead and open up MS Teams and we'll take a look. I've got the brand new MS Teams open here. Now, make sure that you read through this. If you are in another class, you don't really have to read past here. I do have a final couple paragraphs that are different down here. My outcomes for the course, why I'm teaching, what I want to teach and leave you with that will value for you in your future career, okay? So make sure you read this. Make sure you don't hit start a post, but instead reply to this post, okay? It also details what we'll be using this for. We'll use this a lot for the participation assignments, giving you the opportunity, even in an online class, to practice soft skills, which we'll detail more in just a minute. So you've got all that information there, links here. You should have received an invite to the MS Teams for this course. If not, reach out to me, or if you added the course late, reach out to me, send me a quick email, say I'm not in MS Teams, and I will send you a link so that you can add that, okay? Now, down here is my calendar. This is all of the college stuff that I might have going on. It's not all of it as I work on projects. If you read that MS Teams, you'll realize that instructors, especially professors, do more than just teach students. But regularly scheduled, guaranteed, I'll be online. Office hours are 10 a.m. to 11:30 on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Again, though, you can chat me at any time, day or night. If I'm available, I'm gonna answer, okay? Same thing with Teams. Textbook information is here. So again, I kind of went over this, but you'll find this information. Not gonna spend a bunch of time telling you how to navigate Canvas. By now, you should know how to do that. And if not, please do reach out. I'm happy to help you, but I don't need to waste everyone's time with that information. Week one, this is what's covered. First of all, there's a time management estimate. These are times at the end of the term. You will fill out a customized student survey, anonymous, for this class. You're going to detail how much time you spend. My estimates here are based on that. You'll step through this material, make sure you cover it all. Make sure you do all the work, meaning make sure you consume the lecture videos. Make sure you read the chapter. Some people like to read the chapter and then do the lectures so that they get a better understanding of the outcomes, okay? So however you best consume the material, I never suggest waiting to the end of the week. We'll talk about that more in just a minute. But there is a typical week. Anything that's graded will be down at the bottom under required assignments. I've actually renamed that. I'll probably rename that to graded activities in this class as well. This video here, by the way, you better be listening to this video, but you have the opportunity for your first performance points, which are detailed in the course syllabus. You can earn 5 performance points by sending me an email right now that says in the subject line, CIS244. All emails that you send, I want you to preface them with capital C, capital I, capital S, 244. If you reviewed the instructor information, you saw that little tidbit. And then a detailed subject, send me one that says CIS244, I watched Welcome to Course Week video, something like that. You know, say hi, do whatever. You'll earn 5 performance points right off the bat so that I make sure that you consume this information in a timely manner. Again, attendance requirement 1, you'll find details there. 2, you'll find details there. Remember, those are due at noon, this one on Wednesday. This one will open up at 12:01 on Wednesday and is due Thursday at 12 p.m. noon. So again, don't miss those deadlines. You'll be automatically withdrawn from the course if you do. We already talked about all this, so that all looks good. Please let me know if you have any questions. Now, also in this class, not only are you going to practice and demonstrate the outcomes and the technical skills required to be successful in your future career, the reason why you're here at college, but most importantly, you're also going to get the opportunity to demonstrate soft skills. Now, when we talk about soft skills, we're focusing on these skills here. Just do research. Employers need soft skills. Just Google soft skills employers want in 2024 or 2023. You'll find enough information. But if you also Google Perkins Employability Skills Framework, you will find this. Over the past few years, employers have been begging for people that not only have, especially in IT or technical careers, not only have the technical information and the technical abilities, but also have these soft skills. Skills like critical thinking, resource management, time management. So as we talk about time management, you get to practice that here by meeting due dates and making sure you're not procrastinating. The number one reason why students end up dropping my courses that they tell me they drop because of is procrastination. They wait to the last day. They realize there's too much work to do in the last 4 hours. You know, they started at 6 p.m. on Monday. They've waited a whole week. They don't get it done. They get behind quickly. They end up dropping the class, thus getting zero return on their investment for this course and end up having to pay for the course again. So the course becomes twice as expensive. And if you're on financial aid, even more expensive when you pay that back. So I don't want to see that happen. Folks, if you are challenged with time management, it is not part of my job, but I do some personal mentoring on the side to help students succeed in these professional soft skills. So interpersonal skills, the ability to communicate is on here, you know, the ability to manage your feelings, your temper, your whatever, work in teams, work with challenging people. It's all embedded in here. I do encourage you to go out and read that. Finally, this is a fairly new article, October 5th, 2023, that details as it pertains to cybersecurity. And by the way, you'll find articles that say information technology, technology jobs, web developers, etc. What are employers looking for? Well, communication, critical thinking, problem solving, teamwork, and definitely attention to detail. So you'll get an opportunity to practice all of that here in this course. Attention to detail would be finding and completing those performance point challenges within the course, which helps you, I guess you could say, pad your grade for if you do an assignment that doesn't turn out as well, or you have test-taking anxiety and you do well on the homework but not well on the tests. Those performance points, which are not extra credit, again, read the syllabus, will give you an opportunity to help you with your grade. All right, folks, that's enough for me. I try to keep these below 15 minutes. Reach out if you have any questions. Have a great term. And remember, I am available outside of office hours. All you have to do is reach out, and I'll reach back. Take care.